Now, in this chapter, we will discuss Rizal's tour of Europe. The question is, why would Rizal tour Europe? Number one is he was able to complete his novel in Germany. And the reason behind that is because of the person under the person of Viola. So Viola here is the reason why Rizal was able to complete the publication of his novel, Noli Me Tangere. Ang tour niya sa Europe is his reward. His reward for himself for accomplishing his task, which is to publish his novel. Almost na tong hindi na-publish kasi nga wala siyang resources because of some setbacks that he experienced in Calamba. So his brother wasn't able to send some allowances for Rizal to spend in Europe. That's why it's very hard for Rizal to spend some expenses in terms of the cost in publication ng novel niya. Now, ito yung itinerary ni Rizal sa Europe. First, from Germany, dito na na-publish, na-complete yung novel niya. And then, there's a lot of places that he go through in Germany. From Germany, he went to Czech Republic, dalawang cities, Limeridge and Prague. And then, from these areas, he went to Hungary, Austria, Switzerland, then balik ulit sa Germany, Munich, Nuremberg, and then sa Switzerland, and then sa Italy. So this is the reward of Rizal after niyang makomplete yung Noli Me Tangere. Meron na siyang expenses, meron na siyang allowance. That's why he wanted to reward himself. So let's check. So from Madrid, nakompleto niya yung medicine studies niya. He went to France, he went to Germany, he went to Czech Republic, he went to Hungary, he went to Austria, he went to Switzerland, and then he went to Italy, in Rome, Italy. Tapos, bumalik na siya ulit sa Spain. Now, let's go to Dresden first. This is in Germany. So again, finally, Rizal was able to receive his allowances from his brother, Pasiano. And because of this, he was able to repay. He was able to return the money that he loaned from Viola. Viola, again, tandaan natin yung word na letter V. This is Viola. This is the portrait of Viola. Isa siya sa mga pinakamayaman na tao sa Bulacan. So, Viola lend some money to Rizal so that Rizal could publish his novel. Pinahiram niya ng pera sa Rizal. Nung dumating yung allowance from Pasiano, Rizal was able to repay and return the money that he loaned from Viola. And because of that, the two of them is now ready to tour Europe. And this is Dresden, Germany. And then sakto, nung papunta nila sa Dresden, Germany, it coincided with the regional floral exposition. Now, again, remember Rizal was a botanist. So his interest is very fascinated in different kinds of flowers and plants. Again, Rizal's favorite flower is the forget-me-not flower. So sakto, merong exposition. Merong floral exposition sa Dresden, Germany. And then in Dresden, he also went to a museum of art, visited the museum of art. And then he was very interested dun sa painting ni Prometheus Bound. Now, who is Prometheus? Prometheus is a Titan god. Titan god. And then, anong ginawa ni Prometheus? Bakit siya nakataling nakagapos dito? And then, there's an eagle there. Prometheus stole the fire from the gods. The fire is very significant in the progress of our civilization as human beings. Now, the reason why we were able to evolve according to the mythologies, the reason why we're able to achieve development in our civilization is because of Prometheus. Prometheus gave the fire to humans. Dahil si Prometheus stole the fire from the gods. Maraming simbolismang fire. we're able to cook our food, and fire symbolizes knowledge. So binigay sa atin ni Prometheus to, fire. From fire, we achieve development and progress in our society. Now, dahil nga ninako to ni Prometheus, as a penalty, he was bounded. Kaya siya nakalagay doon, bound. Inali siya, ginapo siya dito sa bato. He was bounded there eternally. That's the eternal torment penalty of Prometheus. And then, habang nakatali dito si Prometheus, his liver is to be eaten by the eagle in eternal loop. So, paulit-ulit. Halimbawa, kinain na ng eagle yung liver niya. Kinabukasan, mag-heal yun, yung pain na naramdaman ni Prometheus. The pain would heal itself. The wound would heal itself. Babalik ulit yung liver. And then, kinabukasan, ganun ulit. The eagle would try to eat the liver of Prometheus again. So, yun yung penalty ni Prometheus. Eternal loop. Now, what is the significance of this painting to Rizal is the fire. Yung fire na binigay sa atin ng Prometheus, and then yung sympathy ng isang Titan God to humanity. So, merong kahit na Titan God siya, kahit na medyo superior yung status niya sa buhay, he was able to at least assist humanity, isang inferior race, to progression. That's why this painting was very significant to Rizal. And then in the same area, Dresden, Germany, Rizal was able to meet Jagor. So ilang beses ko na inulit to si Jagor in my previous slides. Jagor, the author of The Travels in the Philippines. Ito yung actual portrait ni Rizal to Jagor. So they met Jagor in Dresden, Germany. Kasi isa to sa mga binabasa ni Rizal sa Ateneo, na favorite book niya. Jagor claimed that our country would be colonized by America. So, meaning to say, we will eventually be separated from the colony of Spain. Kasi almost 300 years, we are under the power of Spain. And then, Jagor also criticized the kind of government system that Spain has. That's why medyo interested si Rizal dito, at makita mismo si Jagor, malamang tinanong ni Rizal kung paano niya nasabi that our country would be sold or at least be freed from the powers of Spain. Imagine 300 years, paano na lang ibibigay ng Espanya ang bansa natin sa ibang bansa. And then Jagor, nakilala rin ni Jagor si Blumentritt. Again, si Blumentritt, ang interest ni Blumentritt is our language. So, Rizal wanted to meet Blumentritt after Jagor. Now, Jagor advised Rizal to inform Blumentritt in advance that they are going to visit Blumentritt. Kasi Blumentritt might be shocked. Sinabi niya yung word na shock. So, most probably, medyo may sakit sa puso si Blumentritt. That after, if we without the notification, kung hindi niyo mananotify si Blumentritt or ma-advise about your visit, he might be shocked. So sabi ni Jagor to Rizal, please try to advise in advance that you're going to visit Blumentritt. So this is the actual portrait of Rizal on his face. Now, the reason why Rizal drew himself is because this is the only way that he could advise or inform Blumentritt about his appearance. Kasi hindi pa naman uso yung technology that time. Now, this it's the only way that Rizal could inform Blumentritt on how he looked. So, ito yung ang pinadala ni Blumentritt, pinadala ni Rizal to Blumentritt, his own portrait. So Pepe sent a sketch of himself to Blumentritt, and then they met in a railroad station. So ito yung resolution nila, remedy nila for Blumentritt not to be shocked. So from Dresden, punta tayo ngayon sa Lemeritz. Lemeritz is in Czech Republic. So si Viola, again ang kasama niya, pumunta sila sa Czech Republic, and then they went to a beer garden. Ang beer garden looks like this. So what did they do in the beer garden? including Blumentritt. The mayor of that town asked Rizal kung paano niya natutunan yung Germany, yung German language very fluently, kasi Rizal was very fluent in speaking the German language. Now remember, it was the same reason why Rizal was the chief of police of Germany was convinced that Rizal was not a spy, was not a French spy, because Rizal was able to explain himself fluently using the German language. So the mayor asked Rizal kung gaano kahaba niya natutunan yung German language, and then Rizal, in as a response, he learned it only in 11 months. So this is a beer garden. And then Rizal also informed Blumentritt that he forgot his diamond stick pin sa isang hotel. Kasi eventually Rizal would want Blumentritt to acquire the diamond stick pin para maibalik kay Rizal. Kasi pwede niyang isanla ulit just in case na mawalan siya ng pera. So this is Rizal's contingency plan just in case he might lose money again. Lemeritz, Germany. He lost this one in Hotel Krebs. Ito yung actual Hotel Krebs sa Lemeritz. It's in Czech Republic. So from Dresden, Lemeritz, punta na tayo ngayon sa Prague. Now in Prague, Rizal visited the tomb of Copernicus. Now why would Rizal visit the tomb of Copernicus? Copernicus is a very significant person during the Renaissance period. Renaissance period is a period that comes right after the Dark Ages. Dark Ages, ito yung panahon na kung saan suppressed yung knowledge of people. Copernicus is a scientific person. He relies too much on science and not on religion. So si Copernicus is a very significant person, kilalang tao during the Renaissance period. Renaissance means rebirth. Rebirth of science, kasi ang science developed during the Greek civilization. Tapos nag-decline to during the Roman civilization because of religion. Ang namayagpag after the Roman civilization, it's her Dark Ages, wherein friars and the church became very influential. Influential in terms of governing the kingdom of rulers. Now, nung nawala na yung Dark Ages, bumalik na yung Renaissance. Ito yung pinaka-critical na tao during the Renaissance period. Why? Because Copernicus maintained that the center of the universe was the sun. He used his observation, he used science. Now, prior to this kind of knowledge, ang pinaniniwalaan ng lipunan, ang pinaniniwalaan ng simbahan was the earth was the center of the solar system or the universe. Other planets including the sun revolves around the earth. Now this, the only basis that the church had was it has its basis from the Bible. So meron na tayong dalawang nagko-conflict: Copernicus, the man of science, and then versus the church. The church would claim this one, geocentric belief. So Copernicus would believe the heliocentric principle. Helium means sun. So ngayon, if you will be the public, sino paniniwalaan mo? The belief of the church or the belief of a specific person, a single person, Copernicus? So mahirap paniwalaan si Copernicus kasi matagal yung pinaniwalaan yung simbahan. Pinaniniwalaan nila the center of the solar system was the earth. Now, anong ginawa ngayon kay Copernicus? Copernicus was considered as a heretic, a sinner. A sinner kasi yung turo na tinuturo ni Copernicus is actually against the teachings of the church. Is actually against the teachings of the Bible. So if people would believe those people who would want to believe the teachings of Copernicus would be executed or will be considered heretic. Or baka magkaka-mortal sin sila. Pag nagka-mortal sin kayo, masusunog kayo sa dagat-dagatang apoy. So a lot of people were very scared and afraid of the church. Kaya siya tinawag na Dark Ages. Kinukulong na lang nila yung kanilang interest sa loob ng bahay nila. That's why a lot of scientists that time would start their laboratory underground. So this is the actual photo of the tomb of Copernicus in Prague. And ito yung basis ng simbahan, why the earth is the center of the universe. It's written in Sun and Chronicles. The world is firmly established, it cannot be moved. So hindi gumagalaw ang mundo. This is exact opposite of what Copernicus was claiming. The earth is moving. So sino ngayon ang tama, the church or Copernicus? The Lord set the earth on its foundation, it can never be moved. So hindi dapat gumagalaw ang earth. Pero dinidiin ni Copernicus na gumagalaw ito, Ecclesiastes. And the sun rises and sets and returns to its place. So sino ang gumagalaw? Ang gumagalaw is the sun. Heliocentrism. That's Copernicus. He used his observation using the parallax principle. And then geocentrism is the teachings of the church. Si Copernicus, pinaniwalaan heretic. That's why he was executed and he was imprisoned. Kaya medyo significant yung ganitong visit ni Rizal kay Copernicus. So from Germany, Rizal and Viola went to Czech Republic. From Czech Republic, he went to Vienna, Austria. Vienna is known for beautiful buildings. Vienna, Austria. And then he received a message from Blumentritt that he found the diamond ring, the diamond pin. And Rizal was very relieved. Sabi ni Blumentritt, he was able to forward the diamond pin to Rizal. And Rizal was able to receive the diamond pin. So from Dresden, Limeritz, Czech Republic, from Prague, punta tayo sa Austria, and then the Danube River. Ito yung Danube River, nag-extend siya from Hungary to Vienna to Austria. Vienna, and then Rizal traveled from Vienna, Austria to Linz, Austria using the Danube River. So he traversed the river using a steamer. Anong natagpuan ni Rizal? Rizal was able to compare a new kind of practice being done by these Europeans while they were eating. Kasi si Rizal was very accustomed in using table napkins na cloth. And then he was surprised that Europeans are now using papers as a table napkin. Sabi ni Viola and then Rizal, which is more hygienic? The disposable brown paper napkins or the table cloth napkins? Sabi nila mas hygienic to kasi medyo disposable to. There's no need for people na labahan to. So economic wise, madali itong madispose. So for them, it's more hygienic. From Vienna to Linz, Austria hanggang sa Switzerland. Nag-travel yung steamer from Austria, Danube River, and papunta sa Switzerland. Now, Rizal and Viola witness the Rhinefall waterfall in Switzerland. So the waterfall looks like this. From Switzerland, punta tayo sa Munich, Germany. So anong gagawin nila sa Munich, Germany? They went to Munich to taste the world's famous Munich beer. Ito yung actual beer coming from Munich, Germany. Ito yung Oktoberfest. Oktoberfest na kinopya natin. Sila yung unang nag-practice ng Oktoberfest sa Germany kasi the place is known for good beer. So from Munich, Germany. Punta tayo sa Nuremberg, Germany. Why would Rizal go to Nuremberg? Again, because of the church. Church pa rin. During the Dark Ages, na kung saan the friars, the church is very superior. Knowledge is being suppressed. All those who go against the teachings of the church are being executed using these torture devices. This is the Iron Maiden. Ang Iron Maiden, parang ilalagay ka dito sa torture device na to, na kung saan may mga pako. Tapos, upon execution, isasarado to, na kung saan mamamatay ka. Ito, ganito yung HP niya. Para siyang kabaong na punong-puno ng pako. To torture people who would go against the teachings of the church. Ito, meron silang piglory, meron silang iron boot, meron silang other torture devices. So they would torture people who would go against the teachings of the church. This happened during the Dark Ages or during the Inquisition. Inquisition meaning to say you are going to be asked. Kasi may inquiry. You're going to be asked if you actually committed the mistake, the errors, the offense. If you really offended the church. And then you need to confess to the priest. Kailangan mo mag-umpisal ng kasalanan mo. Pag nakumpisal mo na yung kasalanan mo, doon ka patatawarin. Yun nga lang, ito-torture ka. Ito-torture ka to punish the sins made by the body. So it's a justice system of the Roman Catholic Church whose aim was to fight against heretics. That's why tinawag siyang Dark Ages. So punta na tayo sa Geneva. From Nuremberg, punta tayo sa Geneva. So sa Geneva, Pepe went rowing sa Leman Lake in Geneva, Switzerland. Ito yung Geneva, Switzerland. So most probably dito siya nag-practice ng rowing. Ito yung rowing. Ito yung Leman Lake or Leman Lake in Switzerland. Now while he was staying there, he received a news coming from his fellow Filipinos that there was an ongoing exhibit of igorots that was happening in Spain, in Madrid. Mayroong exhibit ng igorots na mga anthropologists. They were exhibiting the culture of the igorot. Ganito yung isura ng mga igorot sa Benguet province. And then they were mocking the culture of these igorots because of their type of dress, kasi nakabahag lang sila. So minamak nila yun. Mock means ginagawang katatawanan, except for a single newspaper, which is the El Liberal. According to the El Liberal, mockery is not consistent with human dignity. So it's type of bullying na hindi dapat pinapractice ng tao. Kasi it's against human dignity. Kasi itong mga to, tao rin nito. Nagkataon lang ganito yung kultura nila. That's why culture is very relative. Depending on the which a person actually belongs on a specific race or culture. Nakadepende ang katamaan ng kultura na kung saan nabibilang ka. Kung hindi ka nabibilang doon, ibig sabihin, it's something foreign to your eyes. Ibig sabihin, pagdating sa ganung sitwasyon na kung saan hindi ka naman nabibilang sa grupo nila, sa pananaw mo parang katatawanan to, sa pananaw mo parang mali ito. That's why culture will always be relative. Relative, ibig sabihin, nagiging tama to kung kasama ka or nabibilang ka sa grupo nila. Kung hindi ka kasama doon, it becomes questionable. Questionable siya for those Spaniards who don't belong on this race. Hindi siya questionable kasi nga these igorots are Filipinos. So medyo na disappoint and upset si Rizal because of the treatment made by some of the anthropologists and some of the Spaniards to the igorots. Na kung saan ang ibang mga igorot namatay na sa lamig because of pneumonia. Kasi isipin mo ganito yung suot nila nandun sa Espanya na iba yung climate. from Geneva, Rizal went to Italy. Now, this is a TV series that you can watch in Netflix. It's a story about gladiators. Now, who are gladiators? Again, yung gladiator po is the subject of Juan Luna in his painting Spoliarium. These gladiators are slaves of the Roman Empire. Yung gladiators na to are slaves. They are objects of entertainment. Entertainment na kung saan nagpapatayan sila sa Coliseum. So, do they have any freedom? They don't have any freedom. Kasi nga, slave sila. So, kaya again, pumunta si Rizal sa Italy kasi nga, Rome is known for such kind of culture. Yung mga gladiators and then yung slavery nila. So, Rizal went first to Rome, Italy, dun sa Capitolium. Bakit Capitolium? Because Capitolium is the epicenter of the Roman Empire. And then, Rizal went to the Tarpeian Rock. Ito yung Tarpeian Rock. Bakit siya pupunta sa Tarpeian Rock? Medyo bangin yan. Pagdating mo sa taas, during the Roman civilization, yung kasagsagan ng Roman civilization, those who go against the Roman Empire are executed here in this site. So it's an execution site. So paano sila ina-execute? Inatapon sila sa bangin. Or minsan, dun mismo sila papatayin sa tuktok nung Tarpeian Rock. Now, why would they do that? Because this is the actual location of the Tarpeian Rock. Now, before they're going to execute the person, titingnan nila ngayon yung ganda ng buong Roman civilization. So, ibig sabihin, bago ka mamatay, ang makikita mo yung beauty ng Roman Empire. Ito yung ini-infuse na mindset doon sa mga mamamatay na bago ka mamatay, before you die, ito yung makikita mong kawalan. Ito yung makikita mong ang last image that you will see before your death, before death comes, is the power of the Roman Empire. Kaya siya sa Tarpeian Rock nilalagay. Ito yung magiging kawalan mo. Ito yung mananatiling tatatak sa isip mo. Ito yung dadalin mo sa kabilang buhay, ang kapangyarihan ng Roman Empire. Pumunta rin sila sa amphitheater. I-check yung amphitheater. This is where slavery ng gladiators are being held. Nandito yung public, nanonood sila dito. Tapos yung labanan ng mga gladiators, dito ginagawa. So yung structure, yung architectural type ng amphitheater was copied hanggang ngayon. Meron tayong Araneta Coliseum na kinopya sa architecture ng Roman civilization. That's why the Roman civilization was very advanced during its time. Hindi lang sa knowledge, kundi pagdating sa arts and then architecture. So this is still the amphitheater. Amphitheater is a structure for entertainment. So lahat ng mga entertainment and art related dito ginaganap. Including the show on gladiators. And then Rizal also went to St. Peter's Square, Vatican, Italy. So again, gusto makita ni Rizal yung kapangyarihan ng simbahan. Rome is in Italy, Vatican is in Rome. Now let's discuss the first homecoming of Rizal. After matapos ni Rizal yung tour niya, he decided to go home. He decided